about Internet of Things. That's why we are here, no?
Yes.
Right? So, I will make an introduction about myself. I'm Rodrigo Carvajales from Argentina. I've been working for the last 2 years in Internet of Things. And before, I was working with wireless sensor networks back in Argentina, and nowadays in the Theoretical Institute in Italy, in Trieste. And we've been following this new technology for the last 2 years. It's a technology that came from microprocessors, embedded systems, wireless sensor networks, and now we are grouping all the technology and we are calling it Internet of Things. So if we go to this interesting website called Thingful, we can see all over the world connected devices to the internet. So these are sensors, devices that are connected to the internet that we can ping it. We can have a connection to these devices all over the world. But if we pay attention to this picture, we see that we have a lot of devices connected in North America, a lot of devices connected in Europe, but we are having a big hole in South America, in Africa, and also in Asia. And if we focus, we are here in Algeria, north of Africa, we see that we are lacking a lot of devices to connect to the world, to the internet. So, in 2014, it is said that there were nearly 2 million devices connected to the internet. But this is just the top of the iceberg, because it is expected that in 2020 there is gonna be 8 billion devices connected to the internet. So it's a technology that it is growing day by day. And this is a picture of the news about Internet of Things. And if we take a look, it is a technology that started 2 years ago to focus on the Internet of Things. And it is growing day by day, like exponentially. So it's a technology that it is new, and we are having a new possibility, a chance to be part of it. And if we search in Google about IoT, we are having more than 42 million results about IoT. And if we look for Google Scholar, so that means research papers and things about IoT, there are more than 150,000, but not compared to the amount of information that we are having. So it means that it is a technology which still needs to be studied and developed. What does Cisco says about Internet of Things? They expect in 2020, we saw in the previous slide, 8 million. They said more than 50 million devices connected to the internet. So that's a lot, at least. So let's look for a definition. Let's see what, because to have a clear definition about IoT is not that easy, because it involves many technologies, devices, the cloud, the consumption, power consumption, and there's many things that we need to take care of it. So what does Wikipedia say? So what do we do every day? We want to know something nowadays. We do Google, and the first web page is Wikipedia. So let's see what does Wikipedia say. It says it's a technology with objects that are connected to the internet, which are, we can identify every device connected to the internet with an electronic software sensors and the network connectivity to collect data from the environment, to put it on the website in an internet-like infrastructure. And what does Cisco, which expects to have a lot of devices connected in the future, what does Cisco say? It's more simple. They say just smart object connected to the internet. So doesn't say much, but they focus on business because they expect to enhance the productivity, to have new business model. That's why we are here. We want to have new business models and to revenue, to have new revenue streams. So it seems to be something easy. We connect things to the internet. We have access to this, but we have a big background. So we are going to have our smart devices measuring our health, measuring the ambient, sending data to the internet. So this is, in a simple way, what it is expected about Internet of Things. But also Internet of Things is, there's an interesting project, which is called Ambient Umbrella, which you have your umbrella at home, and it will connect to the internet, will look for the weather forecast, and if it is going to rain, it will start to light a LED. So when we go outside, it will remind us to take the umbrella, because it is going to rain. So Internet of Things has many, many, many different applications, like smart houses, smart home. We had a lot of projects here about smart homes. Healthcare is another important application in Internet of Things. Safety, intelligent buildings, energy saving. We had another some projects here. Predictive maintenance. Enable new knowledge about plantations and weather with weather station, weather forecast. So there are many applications. The spectrum is wide open. We have a lot of work to do. But what is going to happen? I have this slide that I like it. It is, what is going to happen? So we have our alarm that is connected to the internet that is going, so we settle this alarm to wake up us at 7 a.m. But it will look at the traffic jam in the morning, so it will wake up us 15 minutes in advance, because there's a lot of cars on the road. So we will need 15 minutes in advance to wake us to go to work. But at the same time, the alarm will check our car, how is everything in the car, so if it is okay, or we need fuel, so it will wake us up 5 minutes in advance. And for example, we have a meeting and our partner had a problem and he cannot come, so it will let us sleep 15 more minutes, or so half an hour, because this meeting was cancelled. So with it, I think that everything will be connected, so we will have have a huge amount of data processing all the time, and devices taking decisions. So I think this is a little bit future prediction about IoT, which means that we will have to take care about a lot of things, because there will be machines taking decisions, there will be a lot of information and data which needs to be processed. And which are the challenges? I divide the challenges into three items. So it is, in a way, we have internet, which is how the device will be connected. We have devices, so things connected to the internet, and all the information that we are collecting with the sensors. So what is going to happen with internet? I will show just few challenges. There are many, but in these three topics I will show a challenge. So if we want to have all the devices connected to the internet, and we want to reach the device connected to the internet, one challenge is, you know, that to reach a device on the internet we need an IP address, and IPv4 is already there are no more addresses, so we will need to implement IPv6, which give us a lot of opportunity, for example, to put IP address to our light bulbs, so to our lights, so we will directly ping to our lights to switch it on and off. So IPv6, we think that it is the future, and we need to take care about IPv6. What about devices, things? We have from the 60s, we used to have a computer, a huge computer, for 10 people in a room, consuming a lot of power. So this was changing because of technology improvements. Microcontrollers are smaller and consume less power, and radios are more powerful. And we reached the day that we started to have one computer per person. But nowadays we are having a lot of devices and computers and embedded system and in a small device without being extremely powerful, but good enough to make the communication and to let us connect it to the internet. For example, the last device that we bought 3 weeks ago, it is called SensorDAC, and it has an RM3 microprocessor, a Bluetooth radio, it has 10 sensors on it, and it runs only with a cell battery for, they promise, more than 1 year. In this small device we have all of this. So the power is an issue, the communication is another issue. So we will start to have a lot of devices. So we have our cell phone, devices connected everywhere, lights connected to the internet, smart switches measuring consumption. And here we came with a huge, huge problem, is we are going to have, and nowadays it is said that we are taking care of all the information that are being collected by sensors, we are processing only 1% nowadays. So in the future we are going to have even more information, and more, and more, and more. So big data analysis is a big issue that I think it is very important for Internet of Things, and for all of us also. This is a funny lecture because we talk about terabytes, beta. Now we are going to talk about exa, theta, iota, and hella. That I didn't know that it existed, but it's a lot of information. So how do we face these challenges? It's a question. There are a lot of people studying. There are a lot of companies investing money on this technology because the challenge is really big. The technology is quite new. So we are having an opportunity for all of us. So yesterday when I was doing these slides and I reached this point, I said, well, so I'm going to answer this. I don't have an answer, but I know that there are people here that is doing something. This challenge, I think that it is very, very important because we have the big guys from Oredu with the money, the knowledge. We have, for example, people from Open Hardware who I believe that they are in the middle. They have experience. They want to create a community, and we have the community. Now we are a community, all of us. We have skills, we have passion, we saw it, enthusiasm, we saw it with this challenge. And I think that this program is really important because it is taking students. When I was studying, I didn't have the opportunity. I was looking at you standing here, like when I was studying with the cables and everything, and I hadn't had the opportunity like you are having now. So I think this challenge is really important to create the community and to link these three
layers.
Yeah. So congratulations to Oredu and to all of us. Projects were amazing. But this is a challenge, and we had an extremely, not the last one, extremely good jury. Jose, that already did a good presentation, which is the strategy director of Oredu, Koudil Mouloudi, sorry, director of ETSI, Karim Biggie Tricky, General Manager from Intel North America.
North Africa.
Africa.
Not yet America.
In the future. Three years. Sorry, North Africa. Dunia. Who is the Senior Manager at Oredu.
So important.
So we were thinking, what? So we have all your projects, and we were thinking what we needed to take into account with your project. So after some from Jose Maria, we were drawing and writing and taking all the ideas, what we should take into account. And we decided to divide it into four different aspects. So the first one was the idea of the project. So how, if it was related about IoT, if it was original, if it was competitive. Another aspect, the second one, was the team that was participating in this project, so you. We wanted, we take into account if you were passionate, if you were skillful, if you had the knowledge. So this was the second
criteria
that we had into account. Thank you. The third one was the feasibility of the project. So if it was a feasible project in the future. And the fourth criteria was, which is the potential that the project has. So what is the investment that it needs to become a future project? What is the social impact? If you had a business plan already done, or you still needed to do things? So we put these four criteria as the main criteria for choose the winners of the competition. I really want to thank you all. And it's a pleasure for me to be here. I saw extremely good projects. You are skillful and you have the knowledge. So please, if you are not chosen, don't feel bad. It's just the first opportunity that you are having. As I showed you before, there's a lot of opportunity in IoT in this country and in the world. So to finish my presentation, I want to invite you to the next workshop that it is going to be in Trieste, in Italy. It is going to be called Workshop on New Frontiers in Internet of Things. You go to this link and there's an application form. The deadline is on December and it is going to be next year in March. So you are more than welcome to participate. And I hope we will see you again in Italy. Thank you very much. If you want to contact me, here is all my details. Thank you very much.
Thank you.